Good morning. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome. I'm back. Yes, I'm still healing. I am getting better. No, it was not COVID. My doctor pointed out there's this nasty upper respiratory virus that's not COVID going around. It made itself comfortable. Yay. So forgive me as I kind of wear my mask and stay a little bit further away from you for parts of the service. And I am eternally grateful for Pastor Richard, who will be presiding today. As well as you might have noticed, you heard the beautiful sounds of Becky without the image of Becky. That's because she got sick. And so she is home recovering and resting and being treated. But she sent the files in and the files to Aaron, and Aaron worked it out, and through Heidi and Garrett, we still get it. So it's a little bit like karaoke hymns today. So, but we hope that she feels better and she gets better as well. For those of you gathered in this space, I hope you have your bulletins. The inserts are yours to keep. Help, you know, again, help us be good stewards and recycle the big section for the rest of the Epiphany season. For those of you joining us at home, welcome. I hope you have your communion stuff handy if you're going to join us for communion, and all the other stuff is online. Now, there's a couple things to get out before as we begin. Next Sunday, between the services, is the annual meeting of the congregation. It will be streamed as well, so people at home can follow along. There are copies of the annual report back there on the table in the gathering area. It is also being emailed. It is also on the website if you prefer that. If you don't prefer either of those but want a hard copy, there you go. So we will see you next Sunday between services in Werner Hall. So you have to come early. And then an event that obviously got interrupted last year, but one we've done a couple of times. There is a meal pack for Feed My Starving Children at the Oro Valley Church in the Nazarene coming up in February. This is kind of the Lutheran's time slot on that morning. You should have received an email that went out that had a link. It also should have been a part of the email that went out for this Sunday, for today's services. They're really looking to finish up the numbers, so if you're interested in attending, please sign up today. Otherwise, they're going to release it to the general public pretty soon. Highly modified and everything else like that, but it's a great service opportunity if you're interested. If you've done it before and you know what it's like, you haven't done it before, it's a heck of an experience. So I just invite you to check that out. All right. Taking deep breaths is a fun thing for me right now. But we all need to do it from time to time. So I recommend everyone take a deep breath. Rise as you're able. And I invite Pastor Richard to lead us in worship.
Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who creates us, redeems us, and calls us by name. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you and your beloved children. We have turned our faces away from your glory when it did not appear as we expected. We have rejected your word when it made us confront ourselves. We have failed to show hospitality to those you called us to welcome. Accept our repentance for the things we have done and the things we have left undone. For the sake of Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us and lead us, that we may bathe in the glory of your Son born among us and reflect your love for all creation. Amen. Rejoice in this good news. In Christ Jesus, your sins are forgiven. You are descendants of the Most High, adopted into the household of Christ, and inheritors of eternal life. Live as freed and forgiven children of God. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Arise, your light has come, the Spirit's call obey, show forth the glory of your God, which shines on you today. Arise, your has come, fling wide the prison door, proclaim the captive's liberty, good tidings to the poor. Arise, your light has come, the Spirit's call obey. Bind up the broken-hearted ones and comfort those who mourn. Arise, your light has come.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Blessed Lord God, you have caused the Holy Scriptures to be written for the nourishment of your people. Grant that we may hear them, read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them, that, comforted by your promises, we may embrace and forever hold fast to the hope of eternal life, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The reading is from Nehemiah 8. The exiles have returned and rebuilt Jerusalem. Now Ezra the priest reads the law of Moses to them in the public square. When they hear it, they weep for their sins and for the long years in exile. But Ezra reminds them that the joy of the Lord is your strength. All the people of Israel gathered into the square before the water gate. They told the scribe Ezra to bring the book of the law of Moses, which the Lord has given to Israel. Accordingly, the priest Ezra brought the law before the assembly, both men and women and all who could hear with understanding. This was on the first day of the seventh month. He read from it facing the square before the water gate, from early morning until midday, in the presence of the men and the women and those who could understand. And the ears of all the people were attentive to the book of the law. And Ezra opened the book in the sight of all the people, for he was standing above all the people. And when he opened it, all the people stood up. When Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God, And all the people answered, "Amen, amen," lifting up their hands. Then they bowed their heads and worshiped the Lord with their faces to the ground. So they read from the book, from the law of God, with interpretation. They gave the sense so that the people understood the reading. And Nehemiah, who was the governor, and Ezra, the priest and scribe, and the Levites who taught the people, said to all the people, "This day is holy to the Lord your God. Do not mourn or weep." For all the people wept when they heard the words of the law. Then he said to them, "Go your way, eat the fat and drink the sweet wine, and send portions of them to those of whom nothing is prepared. For this day is holy to our Lord. And do not be grieved, for the joy of the Lord is your strength." Word of God, word of life. Please read responsively Psalm 19. The heavens declare the glory of God, and the sky proclaims its maker's handiwork. Although they have no words or language, and their voices are not heard, it comes forth like a bridegroom out of his chamber. It rejoices like a champion to run its course. The teaching of the Lord is perfect and revives the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure and gives wisdom to the simple. The fear of the Lord is clean and endures forever. The judgments of the Lord are true and righteous altogether. By them also is your servant enlightened, and in keeping them there is great reward. Above all, keep your servant from presumptuous sins. Let them not get dominion over me. Then shall I be whole and sound and innocent of a great offense. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 4th chapter, beginning with the 14th verse. Glory to you, O Lord. Then Jesus, filled with the power of the Spirit, returned to Galilee, and a report about him spread through all the surrounding country. He began to teach in their synagogues and was praised by everyone. When he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, he went to the synagogue on the Sabbath day, as was his custom. He stood up to read, and the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was given to him. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." And he rolled up the scroll and gave it back to the attendant and sat down. The eyes of all in the synagogue were fixed on him. Then he began to say to them, "Today this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
There we go. Click, click, click. Testing. 1, 2. Can you hear me now?
There we go. Ah, yes, I am recovering. You know, it's one of those things where, you know, I went on the cruise that we went to on over New Year's, and I'm the only one of the family got sick, so I must have caught it someplace else. Lucky me. One of the comedians made the comment that he was very happy that his wife had given birth to one of their children that was 10 pounds, 14 ounces, so that way she could understand what it feels like for a man to have a cold. Yeah, oh well. Positive that it wasn't COVID or anything else like that. Just, you know, as my doctor said, there's this kind of fun thing going around, and it's it's the difference between getting hit by COVID is like the difference between getting hit by a swarm of mosquitoes or a vampire. They both suck, but one you'll survive. So, oh well. And to be honest, I've drank so much herbal tea in my life and rubbed so much Vicks on me that I sweat essential oils. But maybe I should bottle it, you know, it's the new thing. Oh well. Thank you to all who sent me jokes and puns while I was recovering. You might regret it, but thank you for sending them to me anyways, because you'll get some of them back. It was really nice to be able to go on the cruise. It was so friendly. There was waves everywhere. I know. Well, one of the things unfortunately, sometimes people on cruises, they take advantage of the drink packages and can get a little interesting. And we're down in the piazza section, you know, listening to some music, and there was this guy at the bar who obviously was taking full advantage of the drink package. I mean, couldn't stand upright to save his life or anything else like that. So being good Samaritans and having masks and all that stuff, we found out which room he was, me and another guy, and we helped him to his room. I mean, this guy was just totally incapable of making his way home. And so when we finally got to his room and knocked on the door, his wife answered it and opened it and said, "Oh, thank you. Where's his wheelchair?" Sometimes we think we know what someone needs. Sometimes we pay attention. Sometimes we don't. You know, it's one of those things that I'm sure we've all had those situations. Did you hear me? Were you listening to me? My wife always likes to tell me that I never listen to her. And I always think that's the strangest way to start a conversation. Think about it. Yeah. Do we listen? Do we hear? And what do we hear? That's always the big question, isn't it? After all, we have this lesson where Jesus comes in and tells us the scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing. So what did you hear? Now, Jesus was in the place where he was frequently. He grew up attending synagogue, Shabbat services. He went and attended all of these services from the time he was a kid all the way through. People, in next week's lesson, you'll hear all kinds of things. But, you know, they're used to seeing him there. It's what he did. He probably heard this lesson that he himself read this time countless times by other readers. He heard the word proclaimed in their midst, the law read. But now he stands there, well, actually sits down to preach, that's what you do, and says, "This scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." It's not actually a radical concept if you understand the situation. Jesus is proclaiming that which he grew up with. He grew up time and time again hearing the stories of a word that created, "Let there be," and there was. He heard story after story about how God said and it happened. He heard story after story and proclamations from the previous prophets talking about the fact that the flower fades and the grass withers, but the glory of the Lord, the word of the Lord, will endure forever. He understood that God said, and there was, and it was a creative and redeeming word, because God's word is a verb. It causes something to happen. The scriptures have been fulfilled in your hearing. A lifelong covenant created by the word. A covenant that caused response and reaction on the part of the hearers. You know, O Israel, what you are to do. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind, and your neighbor as yourself. Jesus would later take those two parts of the law and proclaim it. But the prophet Micah, you know what to do. Love justice, do kindness, and walk humbly with your God. Do something. Do you hear it? And you do something? For those of you who are married, were married, you at some point had to say, I do, right? Or I will. Or you wrote some elaborate vows that you had. And then you were done, right? Nothing more was required of you than to hear the other person say, I do. No. Then came the work that started the next morning and kept going, especially when they stopped being cute. Or when they did something or said something you didn't like. Or they didn't hear you. Those words created a situation that calls for response. Jesus gets up and reads this scroll from Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor, proclaim release to the captives, recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. So how does someone know that they're free? What is good news to the poor? It's an action, isn't it? It's something that addresses the need at the time in the situation they are in. We are to, you know, take care of the widow, the orphan, the stranger in our midst. We're to do these things because then we're called to be a part of it. We can pray about it, that's for sure, but at the end of a prayer is this word called Amen. Do we all understand the word amen means it will be so? It's a vote. Yes. And the people at the Watergate heard the law proclaimed to them and they said, amen, amen. Yes, it'll be so. Yes, it'll be so. This word was fulfilled in their hearing. What are you hearing? What are you doing with it? Pope Francis made the comment that of course you pray for the hungry. Then you feed them. That's what prayer is about. Jesus says this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing. Well, maybe part of the struggle is, again, we don't realize it's for us. Or maybe we don't think we can. Or we should. But we are in this together. We are part of the body of Christ. We are ones who are called and blessed by the power of the Holy Spirit for the exact purpose of fulfilling Scripture. The one who said, I came not to abolish the law and the prophets, but to fulfill it. The one who from the cross proclaimed, it is finished. The one who took up the cross for us and then calls us to take up a cross and follow. This Scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing. So may we hear it. May we realize that this comes to us, not just the call, but the capability. Not just the command, but the power to do so. The blessings of the Holy Spirit are ours. Why? Because we're a part of this. How do I know that? Through the gift of baptism. And so I remind you, may you hear this by you saying it along with me. Please repeat after me these promises God gave you in baptism. I've been sealed with the Holy Spirit. I've been marked with the cross of Christ forever. I am Christ's. Did you hear it? This Scripture is fulfilled in your hearing. This Word is alive in you. The Word has become flesh and dwells amongst us in the gift of Jesus Christ. It is yours. It is fulfilled. And remember that God loves you, and so do I. Amen.
Spoken to the people, alleluia. God has spoken words of wisdom, alleluia. God has spoken to the people, alleluia. God has spoken words of wisdom, alleluia. They who have ears, now let them hear. They who would learn the way of wisdom, let them hear God's word. God has spoken to the people, alleluia. God has spoken words of wisdom, alleluia. God has spoken to the people, alleluia. God has spoken words of wisdom, alleluia.
Join me as we confess the faith of the church. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, born from Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again, ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
We come now to the prayers of the people, and each petition is closed by, O Lord, hear our prayer, with a sung response.
God, hear our prayers, we lift them to you. God, hear our prayers, Lord, make our hearts true. God, hear our prayers, we lift them to you. God, hear our prayers, Lord, make our hearts true. Will you make our hearts true?
For all those needing health and healing, especially Marnie, Michaela, Sarah, Sig, Lynn, Jack, Ann, Ryan, Jerry, Becky, Bob, and Gigi. O Lord, hear our prayer.
God, hear our prayers, we lift them to you. God, hear our prayers, Lord, make our hearts true. God, hear our prayers, we lift them to you. God, hear our prayers, Lord, make our hearts true. Will you make our hearts true?
We pray for all those dealing with cancer, especially Shirley, Jeannie, Jordan, Dell, JR, Heidi, Susan, Barb, and Kay. O Lord, hear our prayer.
God, hear our prayers, we lift them to you. God, hear our prayers, Lord, make our hearts true. God, hear our prayers, we lift them to you. God, hear our prayers, Lord, make our hearts true. Will you make our hearts true?
To mourn, especially the family and friends of Hal Wilson, Joel Sierra, Barbara Foor, Larry Cole, Val Hughes, Dickie Molina, and Edna Labrie. O Lord, hear our prayer.
God, hear our prayers, we lift them to you. God, hear our prayers, Lord, make our hearts true. God, hear our prayers, we lift them to you. God, hear our prayers, Lord, make our hearts true. Will you make our hearts true?
Tender our heart to our neighbor. May we find compassion and the strength to reach out and advocate for those who seek help and care from the dangers and struggles and tragedies that they are experiencing. May you bring about a generosity of thought and action. Open our ears, Lord, to your call. Raise up leaders and servants of your kingdom as we may continue to follow you. For families in crisis and those feeling alone and isolated, for those facing major complications due to COVID, care, compassion, justice, and peace for all. For those who are known only to God that are on our hearts right now. O Lord, hear our prayer.
God, hear our prayers, we lift them to you. God, hear our prayers, Lord, make our hearts true. God, hear our prayers, we lift them to you. God, hear our prayers, Lord, make our hearts true. Will you make our hearts true?
In the midst of the darkness and tragedies that threaten to overwhelm us every day, we look for the signs of your light and life in our lives, and we celebrate and give thanks for the birthdays of Kathy Lippert, Ivan Grenfell, Allison Korsmo, Martha Karstedt, and the anniversary of Carolyn and Jack Foote. All these things we pray in the name of Jesus, your Son, our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Awesome. Please share God's peace with one another. At this time at which we usually collect the offering, I would remind those that if you check out the Beautiful Savior website, there are different options for electronic giving. And if you're still using the weekly envelopes, they're on the back shelf in the narthex.
Desert, our hearts will not be drawn to the
Christ died to save. Your hearts lay down before Him when at His feet you fall. When with our lives adore Him who gave His life for all.
Let's pray. Blessed are you, O God, sovereign of the universe. You offer us new beginnings and guide us on our journey. Lead us to your table, nourish us with this heavenly food, and prepare us to carry your love to a hungry world. In the name of Jesus our Lord, amen.
We come now to the communion portion of our service, and those who are here in this worship place will be ushered forward to receive the host from the communion assistant. I will have the gluten-free off to the side. And for those who are joining in this worship via Zoom or Facebook, you're certainly encouraged to participate in the sacrament of the altar. The Word of God transcends time and space, and therefore you are brought into this community of worship by virtue of God's Spirit. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. Gathered around the throne of grace, we pray, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed are you, O holy God. You are the life and light of all. By your powerful word, you created all things. Through the prophets, you called your people to be a light to the nations. Blessed are you for Jesus, your Son. He is your light, shining in our darkness and revealing to us your mercy and might. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. Remembering, therefore, his preaching and healing, his dying and rising, and his promise to come again, we await that day when all the universe will rejoice in your holy and life-giving light. By your Spirit, bless us in this meal that, refreshed with this heavenly food, we may be light for the world, revealing the brilliance of your Son. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. Remember us in your kingdom, dear Lord, and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. As you are ushered forward, I remind you that there's a prayer station over to the to my right, to your left, and please feel free to, after you receive the sacrament, to go there to light a candle and to continue to meditate. Come to God's table. There is place for you and enough for all.
One cup of blessing which we bless. And we, though many throughout the earth, we are one body in this one Lord. Gentile or Jew, servant or free, woman or man, no more. One bread, one body, one Lord of all. One cup of blessing which we bless. And we, though many, many the gifts, many the works, one in the Lord of all. One bread, one body, one Lord of all. One cup of blessing which we bless, and we, one body in this one Lord. Grain for the fields, scattered and grown, gathered to one for all. One bread, one body, one Lord. One cup of blessing which we bless, and we, though many throughout the earth, we are one body in this one Lord.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
We give you thanks, gracious God, for we have feasted on the abundance of your house. Send us to bring good news and to proclaim your favor to all. Strengthened with the richness of your grace in your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
God, who leads you in pathways of righteousness, who rejoices over you, and who calls you by name, bless your going out and your coming in today and forever. Amen.
Go with Christ into a weary world. Share the good news. Thanks be to God.